also joined here by Busia Governor Sospeter, Ojaamong, who is also going to give us his views over this exercise which is going to be happening here at the KICC Commercial Grounds. Karibu sana, Bwana Governor. Maybe you can tell us your views over this exercise which is going to happen here today of collecting signatures. Is Busia ready?
Busia, we are very much ready to start collecting the signatures so that we can approve the views that collected across Kenyans. So we believe not, it's not exactly what we expected, but it goes above 50% of what we wanted, and that's all we want. The rest we can take later on.
But there are those who are saying that counties are not gaining much because already you have been receiving 35% in the past years, rather than this calling that 35% will be enshrined in the constitution right now.
No, I know the previous legislation gave us not less than 15%, but we have been getting less than 15%, not 10% as they have been saying. I think that's a wrong argument. If you calculated it's supposed to be the latest audited accounts, but we are behind by almost 4 years of the audited accounts. So 35% is a plus for us, because if it is adhered to, the counties will get more money and the country will grow economically.
Are you ready, let's say, for a referendum which will be contested, because there are some issues which people have said they wanted to be included in the report and maybe they have not been included because we have not seen the last draft right now?
We have not got the final draft, but from the draft that we had, we are ready for the referendum. And it's not that exactly everything should be there. Definitely there will be some things that will be omitted, but it will be catered for thereafter. But those agree with the majority that has been put in place.
You're calling to those who have mamas, maybe should they join the train which is already leaving the station today?
I think for faster growth of the country, for unity of the people of Kenya, they should join so that we implement this so urgently, so that we can make the corrections and also in the near future. So this is not cast in stone. We say that it can be rectified any time. So let's go with what we have, which is almost over 80% good for everybody. And then the rest can be captured thereafter.
Being a second-time governor, does it give you a chance also to vie for the MP seat so that you can have a chance of getting the cabinet secretary's post? How do you think about that?
No, I think our latest proposal, because we have some governors who are young, they say they go thereafter. They should be given an opportunity to continue contesting. And if this captured, it's well and good for us, because your re-election will be determined by the public, not yourself. So to us, it will be good. But it also gives an opportunity to be nominated as might be cabinet secretaries and other MPs.